Then she's not going to disgrace in the kingdom of God. In the wife, normally the wife is supposed to be the successor of the man, but in spiritual things, sometimes it's different. If that woman was having a calling, every wife of the pastor has a calling. If she was activating that calling, if she was already, you know, living in that calling, she can be there by God. Or if God doesn't choose her to be there, when she comes and take over that mantle, it will not go. God will say, okay, you cannot go. Give it to, this is my son. Give it to that one that Papa raised. Give it to this one that Papa raised. Is there any place of quarreling, my people? Why are people disgracing the Pentecostal movement? This is a movement that has brought deliverance to the world. Why is this? Why is this? Look at a model who have gone to rest. Still shock. Anyway, Jeremiah chapter 17, from verse 9 to verse 10, Bible says, the heart of a man is desperately wicked. That is why I'm so disappointed about people that think that they will not trust God, they want to put their trust in me. Bible says, the heart of a man is desperately wicked. You are with senior committee with Joshua every day. As a son going to the mountain and going to preach and heal people, you are behaving like an angel. And now, Pastor, to rest. You are wrestling. You want to be leader. Over the wife, is it tough for people of God? I came to rebuild the church to stand up against this wickedness. I came to rebuild the church to stand up against this falsehood. I came to rebuild the church to stand up against this hypocrisy. I came to call the church to order. Whosoever sits on a chair, if that is not your chair, sooner or later, that man will give way. There should be no room for fighting. Bible recorded, whether it's Paul who planted, or it's Apollos who watered, it is God that makes it to grow. Should we not give honor only to God? I still remember when we received that news, and I went into prayers, I was seeking the face of God. And God revealed to me how Mama Evelyn Joshua continued with the mission. And in that revelation, the Spirit of God took me and Mama, we went there. And before Papa was going, he called us and placed hands and blessed us. My wife and I, she started from my wife, prayed for her, called me, prayed for me. And as he was doing that, Mama was already leading. And he was telling me on the pulpit that man of God, don't bother, we will continue. Yes. Are you understanding me? I wrote there, I emailed it because, yeah, and during this dark period, I just sent some link and I saw it on Facebook that if you have any testimony or anything to say, you should send it. Some of you must have seen that link that came up. So I saw it, so I wrote there.
Emmanuel, God with us, I am Walter in Bamenda, Cameroon. May the soul of our dearest prophet, Senior Prophet Joshua, rest in perfect peace. His ministry and calling has influenced my life and my calling in such a way that 1 minute cannot express it. But all what I can say is that God used him to give me the calling. And after I was mentored, God still used him to continue directing me. And I just recently had a revelation how Mama Evelyn Joshua continued with the work of God in the ministry. And when he continued with the work of God in the ministry, I came there, Papa was still alive, he prayed for my wife and I, and Mama was telling us that we are going to continue. So I would love to get direction so that I can share other deeper revelation that God has been giving me and how I can find myself in the righteous purpose of God. Emmanuel, God with us. Bye-bye.
Let us pray for God to intervene over the Synagogue Church of All Nations and empower the woman of God for the mission and the task, and for God's will to speak forth. For the will of God to speak, prayer, everybody, prayer, prayer, prayer. Father, your will over the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Father, show for yourself over the Synagogue Church of All Nations. Let every heart captured by the devil over the Synagogue Church of All Nations be delivered. Let every heart captured by the devil over the Synagogue Church of All Nations be delivered. Father, answer your name.
Oh, my church, Yahweh. Be seen, Lord.
Only you be seen.
Oh, Yahweh.
We cry for your church, Yahweh.
For your church, Yahweh.
Only you be seen.
Only you be seen.
Only you be seen.
Only you be seen.
Father, we commit this Nagon Church of All Nations to your hands. Thank you, Father, for answering your name. Thank you for sending your angels for revelations. Thank you for sending your angels for clarity. Thank you, Father, for your grace over your church. Take all the glory, all the honor, and all the adoration. Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, my lover.
Can you explain in this generation that a prophet we have seen show the whole world the power of God and so on, and after his departure to glory, you begin to hear stories, people fighting, stories, people fighting, some fighting to be the leader and so on. Is that not making you know that this society is wicked? You are with me every day preaching, doing this. When I'm gone now, you are fighting my wife. My wife says she has to be leader, and if it is God, she will be. If not God, when she go there, she will say, can't take over, can't take over. Pick up. She's not with disgrace in the kingdom of God. In the wife. Normally the wife is supposed to be the successor of the man. But in spiritual things, sometimes it's different. If that woman was having a calling, every wife of the pastor has a calling. If she was activating that calling, if she was already, you know, living in that calling, she can be there by God. Or if God doesn't choose her to be there, when she come and take over that mantle, it will not go. God will say, okay, it cannot go. Give it to, this is my son. Give it to that one that Papa raised. Give it to this one that Papa raised. Is there any place of dwelling, my people? Why are people disgracing the Pentecostal movement? This is a movement that has brought deliverance to the world. Why is this? Why is this? Look at the model who have gone to rest. Anyway, Jeremiah chapter 17, from verse 9 to verse 10, Bible says, the heart of a man is desperately wicked. That is why I'm so disappointed about people that think that they will not trust God, they want to put their trust in me. Bible says, the heart of a man is desperately wicked. You are with senior prophet Joshua every day. As a son going to the mountain and going to preach and heal people, you are behaving like an angel. And now, pastor, to rest. You are wrestling. You want to be leader over the world. Is it tough for people of God? I came to rebuild the church to stand up against this wickedness. I came to rebuild the church to stand up against this falsehood. I came to rebuild the church to stand up against this hypocrisy. I came to call the church to order. Whosoever sits on a chair, if that is not your chair, sooner or later, that man will give way. There should be no room for fighting. Bible record it. Whether it's Paul who planted, or it's Apollos who watered, it is God that makes it to grow. Should we not give honor only to God? Whosoever wants to occupy any position, it is God that permits. Should we not allow God to decide? Why should we be fighting among us? The Bible record it. If we still fight among us, that means we are still babies that dream men. If we still fight among us, that means we are still babies. Then we must grow in the grace. They are never grew in the grace. I pray to decree over the life of God's children that that will not happen among us. We must grow in the grace. We must grow in the grace. I say we must grow in the grace. It doesn't matter who waters. It doesn't matter who plants. It is God that makes it to grow. It doesn't matter who holds the camera, or who is holding the speaker, or who is holding the mic. It is God that is doing everything for us. It doesn't matter who is working at the toilet, or the one working at the garage. It is about God that is making it to grow. I need to speak to somebody here that we must put our trust in God. Anyone that God chooses to be in the front, let him be in the front. If he's not the one destined by God, sooner or later, he will hand over the garment to another one. That's all. Jesus is alive. Why? Why should we be disgracing Jesus? Why all this fight? If you don't like to come to this church, go to the other one. Stop insulting this one. If you don't want to go to the other one, come here. Stop insulting that one. Let us conserve integrity in the kingdom of God. And God will be very happy with us. Let us conserve integrity. They don't listen to do the things managed by mysterious spirit. How do you want the spirit to walk? When he's fighting, I must be this. Papa, I first came around Papa. I must be this. I first came around Mama. I must be this. All that why? 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16. Bible says, all scriptures are inspired by God and they are used to teach the truth, to rebuke error, to correct fault, and to give direction for a right living. To give direction for a right living. Do not harden your heart when the word of God come upon you. It's because God loves you. Christ, let us pray for God to intervene over the synagogue church of all nations and empower the woman of God for the mission and the task, and for God's will to speak forth. For the will of God to speak, prayer, everybody, prayer, prayer, prayer. Father, your will over the synagogue church of all nations. Father, show for yourself over the synagogue church of all nations. Father, your will over the synagogue church of all nations. Father, show for yourself over the synagogue church of all nations. Father, your will over the synagogue church of all nations. Father, show for yourself. Father, reveal your glory. You cannot be mocked, and your work cannot be mocked. You cannot be mocked at what you have done to your general who have gone to rest, senior poverty, so you can never be mocked. Reveal your will, O Father, and show for your glory. Reveal your way. Reveal your will. Show for your glory. Father, reveal direction. Father, bring revelation. Father, bring true revelation. Father, bring reconciliation. Father, bring love. Father, turn every disobedient heart back to you. Over the synagogue church of all nations. Every member of the team, oh Lord, taken over by the enemy because of the things of the world. Father, we call on you to intervene and turn the hearts of your children back to you. Father, manifest your mighty hand over the synagogue. And let the community of darkness not rejoice. Father, manifest your mighty hand. Let that evil hand causing misunderstanding over the synagogue church of all nations be cut off. Let that hand be cut off. Let that hand be cut off. Let that hand be cut off. Only you should take the glory over your church. Whosoever is planting, whosoever is watering, it doesn't matter. It is you that make it to grow.
Over your church, let only you be seen. Let only you be seen. Over your church, over your church, let only you be seen. Let only you be seen.
Begin to groan on this altar. Begin to groan for God to intervene. Hey, 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 Father, answer your name. Father, answer your name over the synagogue church of all nations. Father, answer your name over the synagogue church of all nations. Let every heart captured by the devil over the synagogue church of all nations be delivered. Let every heart captured by the devil over the synagogue church of all nations be delivered. Father, answer your name.
Over your church, Yahweh. Over your church, Yahweh. Be seen, Lord. Only you be seen. Only you be seen. Over your church, Yahweh.
Over your church, Yahweh.
Pray for your church, Yahweh.
Over your church, Yahweh. Father, we commit this synagogue church of all nations to your hands. Thank you, Father, for answering your name. Thank you for sending your angels for revelations. Thank you for sending your angels for clarity. Thank you, Father, for your grace over your church. Take all the glory, all the honor, and all the adoration. Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Put your hands together for Jesus. can still remember when we received that news, and I went into prayers. I was seeking the face of God, and God revealed to me how Mama Evelyn Joshua continued with the mission. And in that revelation, the Spirit of God took me and Mama. We went there, and before Papa was going, he called us and placed hands and blessed us. My wife and I, she started from my wife, prayed for her, called me, prayed for me. And as he was doing that, Mama was already leading. And he was telling me on the pulpit that, man of God, don't bother, we will continue. Are you understanding me? Man of God, don't bother, we will continue. That's what she was telling me. And in that revelation now, we went, Papa even wanted us to have breakfast with him. But we had already paid for a place beside. So that is how we separated. I woke up, I told my wife that Mama has to consume with this mantle, with the mission. And I wrote there, I stood here, I wrote there, I emailed. If those that receive that email send it forward, someday God will speak over it. I wrote there, I emailed it. Because, yeah, and during this dark period, I just sent some link, and I saw it on Facebook that if you have any testimony or anything to say, you should send it. Some of you must have seen that link that came up. So I saw it, so I wrote there. I wrote it.
Emmanuel, God with us, I am Walter in Bamenda, Cameroon. May the soul of our dearest prophet, Senior Prophet Joshua, rest in perfect peace. His ministry and calling has influenced my life and my calling in such a way that 1 minute cannot express it. But all what I can say is that God used him to give me the calling. And after I was mentored, God still used him to continue directing me. And I just recently had a revelation how Mama Evelyn Joshua continued with the work of God in the ministry. And when he continued with the work of God in the ministry, I came there, Papa was still alive, he prayed for my wife and I, and Mama was telling us that we are going to continue. So I would love to get direction so that I can share other deeper revelation that God has been giving me and how I can find myself in the righteous purpose of God. Emmanuel, God with us. Bye-bye.
I wrote there, why should I be fired in this kind of a place? Why? If somebody is okay, I will be. Eh? And just because of the father is an elder, allow him be. If he doesn't go, he must hand it over. Can you fight the Spirit of God? Why? But God is a God that answers his children when they groan on his altar. Hallelujah. So everyone, pray for the spawn. God have used this altar to deliver nations. Presidents have gone there on behalf of their nations and so on. It's a special altar. It's an altar of a kind. Sometimes this altar can be raised in a generation one. In a whole generation, that generation passed. It will never come again. Sometime. Pray for the storm. Hallelujah. We should know that sometimes a man of God may not appoint a successor before departing, not because he didn't want to do it. Hallelujah. No, we know nothing. Sometimes appointing a successor, I even discovered that there were witches and wizards around. So who do you think that successor will have left for 2 days? Is somebody understanding? Who do that? Papa now saying, okay, when I will no more be there, this should be my successor. Who do that? They will not have slaughtered that one. Those same people, the network of witchcraft now. Who do that? They will not have finished that one. We know nothing. You may just know that when you go, the Spirit of God will take control. That's all. And if that's what happened, should people need to fight? Fine. You come here, elder is sitting here. Say, you say you want to sit there. You say you want to sit there. And then the elder one sit there. If it's not the will of God, you will get up. Hallelujah. Give preference to elders.
Connect on our Facebook page. Simply type Prophet Walter NN Champions Ministries and click like, and you will always be part of our service.